I am David Hickton from Pitt Cyber, and this is Ask a Professor. What exactly is cybercrime? Cybercrime, in simple terms, means a crime committed over a computer. But it is really a very significant and evolving challenge. In the beginning, early cybercrime was sort of a bunch of individuals. In fact, the first thing we were really watching for was child predators. Children were talking on MySpace or talking over the internet to each other. Someone would impersonate another child and exploit children. And cybercrime evolved beyond that to involve individuals who would steal people's credentials, passwords, social security numbers or driver's license numbers and impersonate them to get credit cards. This individualized crime began to become groups of four, and people would deal credentials with one actor, purchase things anonymously or falsely through eBay and other platforms through another person, receive them through a third person and repackage them, and then through a fourth person do sales and resell this stolen material. Cybercrime then evolved to include nation states and large transnational criminal organizations. And now cybercrime has evolved even further within each of those categories to include ransomware, intellectual property theft, to influence elections. What could we do about cybercrime? Cybercrime is very, very hard to defend. One way to think about it is the people who protect us against cybercrime are like hockey goalies. They're expected to stop every incoming shot, and they're noticed when they do not. The advantage is on the offense for cybercrime. The hacker has the advantage. They are nimble, they are smart, they are digitally proficient, they understand the computer landscape. I think as long as the internet is open, cybercrime is going to be a problem. Our aspiration should not be to take cybercrime down to zero, but we can take responsible steps, both in government and in policy groups like Pitt Cyber, to develop better policies, better programs to reduce cybercrime.